4 o'clock in the morning rain. The last big circus tent is rolling out for another show. This part of circus life would be long gone, except for one man, circus boss Cliff Vargas.
You guys are worse than townies.
Joe, I am so disgusted we have no help to put this tent up here this morning. If you had $35,000 in advance, I could care less. Because if we don't have the tent up, we don't have a show.
From the ringmaster to the kid who sweeps up, Cliff and his tent hold them all together.
I don't feel that anything that's under a building you call a circus. You might call it a variety show or something. But the tent is the whole thing behind the circus. It gets the atmosphere behind it and everything.
But we're kind of gypsies, you know. And we like moving around the country, and the tent is a part of our nomadic way of life.
There's only one star in this show. It isn't me, it's the tent. That's our star. Without our tent, we are nothing.
Grab it again!
This 4-ton tent goes up and down on the average of twice each week. It's sort of like moving the entire contents of your house twice a week. Or more like moving your entire neighborhood. And you can't put up the biggest big top with a machine. Elephants do the work at Circus Vargas. It's tradition. The all-American aroma of elephants and sawdust. The tantalizing temptation to junk out on peanuts, popcorn, oh, and cotton candy. The men of the sledgehammers. And the last roustabout on the tent roof. Everybody has their own story of how they got here.
What'd you do before you were a clown, Jim?
I was in the Navy, believe it or not. I retired after 20 years.
What'd you do in the Navy?
I was in Naval Intelligence. Perfect background for clown training.
I just happened to answer an ad in the newspaper. Circus needing help.
How long does it take to train an elephant, Rex?
Well, it's like raising kids. You really don't get through. You always try to make them a little better all the time. You know, you want your kids to be the better than you were, so, same thing.
Well, my father did the same kind of work I do. Worked the circus equestrian acts. Kind of passed down from family to family.
Billy, why are you a clown?
Oh, I don't know. Well, it seems like when I was born, my mother had a big laugh, so I guess I came from that.
You go on from there.
I was a bartender, sold full of brushes, parked cars, worked in gas stations. Never could figure out what I wanted to do.
Cliff, what are the qualities necessary in being head of the circus?
A darn fool. Really? No. I really, you have to love it. You have to really, truly love it. I'm divorced now, I'm remarried, and my marriage is a circus. I can put the tent and seats up. I've worked with the horses and do everything.
Ladies and gentlemen, the all-new 1979 Circus Vargas souvenir coloring book.
Huh? I mean, you know, the slides, Bill.
It's push and shove and push some more from tents up to lights out. And Cliff Vargas never lets up.
People say you're a grouch. Maybe I am. But I'll holler at people and say, do this and do that. That's the way it is. I love it. Because she's only watching the two indoors. The only way you're going to keep them from running is when they're sitting. I just love running the circus. I've had open heart surgery. The doctor says you shouldn't do this and do that. I ain't worried about it now. All I care about is that we can be successful. Any money the company makes goes back into the company. I want to have the greatest show that you could possibly have together. When you see the tent full of people and the kids, there's nothing can touch it. Believe me, it is just fantastic. I dream and live the circus. That's my entire life.
So in 100 cities, twice a day, Cliff's big top dream becomes everyone's dream.
Descendants of the prehistoric mastodon.
Now come with me where dreams are born and time is never planned. Just think of lovely things and your heart will fly on wings forever.
What? Get out of show business?